Well, it isn't just the last game of the season, but the last game period for both head coaches with their current program. The Idaho Vandals fired head coach Paul Petrino yesterday, and Idaho State announced that they will be letting go Rob Fennessy just 2 hours before kickoff. The in-state rivalry game between Idaho and Idaho State is one of the most exciting games of the year. But most were more preoccupied with what was happening on the sideline of this Bengal Vandals game than what was happening on the field. On Friday, November 19th, the University of Idaho announced they were letting go of head coach Paul Petrino after 9 seasons. Then, less than 2 hours before the 1-9 Idaho State Bengals took on the 3-7 Idaho Vandals, Idaho State University made the announcement that there would be a change in football leadership.
We kind of have this legacy of finding ways to fall short in the strangest ways, and we need to try to make a change and find a leader who will take us from always close. The Bengals are always right there, and we need to go from close to competitive. And it just felt like, given the record this season, that this was the time to try to make that change. It makes sense.
It was an emotional day for the Idaho State coaching staff and the players, but Fennessy said he wasn't surprised with the decision.
I know I had to be a better head coach, and the university, I think they need to move forward, and it's, you know, I can't be upset at the decision because, your record's your record, and bottom line is you got to win games, and when you don't do that, there needs to be a change at the top, and it starts with me.
Idaho State lost 14-0 Saturday to Idaho, the first time all season the Bengals didn't manage getting any points on the board. For now, assistant head coach David Fiafia will serve as the football liaison to maintain recruiting and player contact. And although Fennessy's time has ended at Idaho State, he doesn't plan for this to be the end of his coaching career.
And when you're a football coach, you coach. You can't sit around, you know. And I'm one of those guys that's going to go on a vacation and 2 days in have a heart attack and die because I'm not doing anything. So I need to work and. I'm a coach, and that's what I love to do. So you never know where it's going to take you. You know, that's the beauty of the thing. I never dreamed I was going to be a head coach. I always wanted to be an offensive coordinator, and then all of a sudden I was thrust into this, and I was luckily I feel I was prepared. But no, I don't know what's next. We'll take a little bit of time off and decompress. But you know, you never know. Something could happen in a week. Something could happen in a month. Something could happen in March. So that's how this profession goes.